will continue with equilibrium. So equilibrium, what are the types of equilibrium what we have? Let us see what are the types of equilibrium we have. Okay, just a second, students. What are the types of equilibrium? Okay, this is commonly used in number of this one. There are three types of equilibrium. Okay, three or four types. We will see what are the different types of equilibriums. One is mechanical equilibrium, right? So, types of equilibrium. One is mechanical equilibrium. Thermal equilibrium, when the heat is not there. Okay, mechanical equilibrium, when is there, there is no velocity, right? No, not velocity, no acceleration, very important. Mechanical equilibrium means no acceleration, not no forces. Forces are balanced, correct? Okay, but no acceleration. Okay, so you can say plus means forces are balanced. You can say that. Okay, thermal equilibrium, temperature is constant. That means there is no net heat flow, no net heat transfer. Correct, students? Then you have chemical equilibrium. Okay, say I will say this is M, this is T, and this is C. Okay, chemical equilibrium. No chemical reactions. Occurring in the system. So when you see mechanical equilibrium plus thermal equilibrium plus chemical equilibrium, all together gives thermodynamic equilibrium. Simple, this you know, students, correct? Write this down. Then we will go to the next slide. Nothing correct. Next, we will see process. Process path. Okay.
Done,
very good. Okay, next one. Next part, when you have, okay, another point which is important is what is a process. Okay, if you say a process, yeah, any doubts here?
Previous
slide, very much not done. Okay, write it down, students. Slowly you can write, don't have to worry. Okay,
that's
it. Done.
Yes, sir.
Very good. Okay. So now, next one. Next, let us see what is a process. When you say a process, process means when you say change of system, process refers to change of state of system. Process refers to change of state of a system from one to another, from one to another, from one state to another state. State is made out of properties. Okay. Next is path. The you can say from initial state to final state, you can say, okay, that's also you can say, okay. So process is series of state, process or sorry, path is series of states, series of states, series of states, okay, through which the system passes through series of state through which the system passes through from the initial, starting from the initial to the final state, starting from the initial to the final state. Of the process. Okay. So what happens if I have a process? Process is going from, say, point one in a state. This is state function, say V, this is P. We can say that. Okay. So it's going from one to two. Okay. The process is from one to two. Okay. The process one, two. Can be achieved through path say A or B or another C. We can go with any path A, B or C. Simple, any path we can. Okay, students, here what I will do is I will, okay, let it be. Okay, can be gone through path A, B or C. Make sense? Then another point is cyclic process. One by one, today there is no other way, students. We have to do all these definition because this is very important. Cyclic process. In the 10 minutes these things are there, then we will start with really interesting one. Okay. Cyclic process, a process whose initial state, which returns to original state every time. Okay. Process that returns to original state. After going through series of states is called a cyclic process. Make sense, students? Very simple. Okay. Slowly we will go. Now this also means in a cyclic process, any property, we say cyclic property is like this. Okay, any change in property x is equal to zero. Okay, so change in property x is zero. Change in property, I'll write in a property, change in property x over a cycle is zero. Is zero. Change in property x over a cycle is zero. Next we will see some of the things which are not properties, like work, heat, length of a curve. These are not properties. Okay, so this is also important in thermodynamics. Okay, Even length of the curve is important in thermodynamics. Okay, let us see that. Then we will say quasi-equilibrium process or quasi-static process. Okay, that's the next one. After that, we will see something called continuum approach. Okay, these are all the things which are not introduced a lot of places. Okay, so that becomes very important. Okay, four people are not there who have come that time. Correct. Anyhow, don't worry. I hope they know that they can attend any number of classes in this week. Okay, anyhow, don't.
Done, sir.
Done. Very good. Now let us go about cyclic process. Not cyclic process, I'm sorry. Equilibrium, quasi-equilibrium process. Very, very important. My first PhD topic, what I wanted to do is on non-equilibrium thermodynamics. Then I felt how difficult it is, then I stopped. Okay. Quasi-equilibrium process. Quasi-equilibrium process or quasi-static process. Quasi-static process. It actually means a slow process. Okay, it means very, very slow process. Okay, let us see. Okay, if during a process, system passes through series of states, okay, that are in equilibrium, equilibrium, okay, that are in equilibrium states, okay, so that at any instant in between the process, a process, the system is in equilibrium, then the process is called quasi-equilibrium process. Then the process is called system is in equilibrium or close to equilibrium. That also we will see. Or close to equilibrium. Okay. Let me put it another way. Okay, if it is in equilibrium, then it is called equilibrium process, then it is called equilibrium process, which is not there at all, which is called equilibrium process. Okay, if the series of states are not exactly in equilibrium but close to equilibrium, but very close to equilibrium, then that process is called quasi-equilibrium process. Quasi means not actually equilibrium, but near about. Okay, it's called quasi-equilibrium process or quasi-static process, because if it is totally in equilibrium, then it cannot go from this state to the other state, is it? External stimulus is needed, obviously. Okay, so we will not see when you have equilibrium. When you say equilibrium, what should it have? Temperature gradient should be absent. Temperature gradient must be absent. Correct, students? Then second point is forces must be balanced. And third one is no chemical reactions. Correct. This is what should happen. Correct. So now when temperature gradient must be absent, so you are heating it. Okay. So there will be one place, there will be more temperature, the other place, other temperature. So what you do, you heat it, you have a pulse, and you wait till the whole system is coming to equilibrium. Okay. And then after it has gone from T1, to T1 plus delta T, again switch on the heater, give a small heat, then T1 to 2 delta T, and it should be such that delta T is very small. Okay, so that if you do, it is quasi static process, and it is really 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 slow, and no process actually is a quasi static process. Okay, it's an idealism. Okay, so how should we go with quasi static process? You should go first, if it is T1, from T1, so it goes T1 plus delta T plus T2. Then next, after this, at instant of time, after the whole system has to go to that, not at a single place. If it is a single place, T1 plus delta T, then it is not quasi-static. The whole system has to come to T1 plus delta T. After the whole system goes to T1 plus delta T, then you supply some more heat, so that it will go with T1 plus 2 delta T. Make sense, students? This way, if you go, that process which takes from T1 to T2 is a quasi-static process. Makes sense? So it is generally not possible for us to go like that. Okay.
Sir, when we
tell me,
when we say temperature gradient must be absent, it's a temperature difference which should be absent, right?
Temperature gradient must be absent, correct?
So how can we go from one temperature to the other, like, in that case?
That's why it is very very, it is close to that. That's why it's always said impossible.
Oh.
It's idealism. all the system what we are doing, all are equilibrium thermodynamics. Okay, so it is non-realistic. That's why we have to go to non-equilibrium thermodynamics. And in non-equilibrium thermodynamics, it is really, really difficult. Okay, mathematics are much more involved in that. Okay, and even in IIT, people do not take non-equilibrium thermodynamics. Okay, I was offered because I did an M.Tech in IIT Madras, no? So I was offered that, but for me also it was very tough for me to do it. Okay. So otherwise, there is one saying by our professor. When I said I need chaotic advection to be done as a, I want to do PhD on chaotic advection. Okay, he said this. Ananji, मैं आपको एक चीज बोलता हूँ. He said in Hindi. I hope everybody understands Hindi. Okay. मेरे दादाजी जो थे ना, वो बहुत हिम्मत वाले थे. मेरे दादाजी बहुत हिम्मत वाले थे. एक बार क्या हुआ, इतने हिम्मत वाले थे कि वो शेर से लड़ गए. किससे शेर लड़ गए? शेर से लड़ गए. फिर क्या हुआ पता है? शहीद हो गए. इज अ वेरी ब्रेव पर्सन. इज सो ब्रेव दैट ही वन डे फॉट विद अ लायन. व्हाट हैपेंड आफ्टरवर्ड्स? He got martyred. Okay, so you should not be like that, is it not? You should take in your mouth what you can achieve, is it not? You should not take more than that. So that's why here also I am saying, go step by step. It is possible. This gate is possible to do. Okay, but step by step. If you think that we have to, sir, some of the students are there who come to me at the end, 1 month. Sir, there is a crash course. Is there a crash course which I can, which I should get cleared in gate within 1 month? No, not there. If you have it with you, then it is there already with you. Clearing is not a great deal. Okay, for clearing you don't need coaching. Okay, for clearing, what happens is if you want to get higher ranks, then you need coaching, because 50 to 60 marks in gate is easy questions. Okay, so if you want to get into PSU, that's why you have to get more than 70 marks out of 100. And it's possible. It is possible. Okay. It is not like CAT exam where you have to struggle. Okay. If you don't have it, you don't have it. If you have it, you have it. That's it in CAT. But in GATE, it is not like that. And through GATE, you can go for Niti Mumbai also, MBA, one of the Ivy League colleges in India. Is it not? Through GATE only you can do MBA. Correct? Yes. Done, students? Is it done?
Yes, sir.
Very good.
Yes.
Okay. Next one. Another point here. Okay. Now let us go with saying what is a property, what is not a property. Yeah, tell me. Tell me. Any doubts? You've not written down? I think somebody had doubt. No? Fine. You can also put the doubts here also, students, keep in mind. You can discuss here, okay? You can discuss things here, okay? So, see if you have that, okay? So, now let us see further, okay? Now, another point, okay? One of the things what we have to see is what is a property, what is not a property. For example, let us take example of point and path functions. Okay, point function, when you say point functions are properties, point functions are properties. Example, you said that pressure, temperature, viscosity, kind of momentum, diffusivity, correct? Then you can say Prandtl number, okay, is a property. Prandtl number is a property. Then what else? Like this, there are a lot of properties which are there, okay? Now, next, these are point function, which are properties, okay? Path functions are not properties. These are called inexact function. It is also called inexact functions. properties are exact functions. What are properties? Properties are exact functions. This is inexact functions. Inexact functions. Example for inexact functions: heat, work, length of curve, etc. These are inexact properties, inexact functions. Okay, no properties. Property, when you say, those are point functions. Now, what is the differentiation between path function and point function? If you consider point function, if I say pressure and volume, and you say this point has a temperature, say enthalpy H. If I say enthalpy H, H1, and here you say H2, which is a function of P1, P2, okay, P1, V1, okay, and this enthalpy is P2, V2, let us say like that, okay. Now, if that happens, okay, this makes it makes things complicated, but still, okay. Now, what happens? H1 minus H2, okay, does not depend on the path followed, that whether we go along A, whether we go along B, or whether we go along C. H1 minus H2 is the same. Okay, H1 minus H2 along A is equal to H1 minus H2 along B, and is equal to H1 minus H2 along C. Does not depend on the path function. Whereas work, okay, 1 to 2, okay, along A is not equal to work 1 to 2 along B, is not equal to work 1 to 2 along C. So W is a path function. For example, you can see this also. See, if you consider volume, it's a point function. So if I say V2 minus V1, it does not depend on how it has been taken, is it not? It depends only on the end points, is it not? Points function depends only on the end points. The differential depends only on the end points. Whereas path function depends on the path which is given. Okay, work and heat are path functions, and those are not properties. Those are inexact functions. Now the next point we have to ask is, sir, what is inexact function? How do we find whether a function is inexact or exact? Let us see. We have done this in mathematics. We are doing it again. Okay, because I promised you that I'll repeat a lot of things. Is it not? This is again repetition, a small repetition. But then we will take an example which is there in thermodynamics only. In mathematics, we have not taken thermodynamics example. We have, our purpose there was to solve a differential equation. Here the purpose is not to solve a differential equation. It is to understand the physics. Okay. So similar way, in heat transfer, see, in differential equations, we have done solving of second order differential equation, correct? But then we have not seen heat and wave equations, correct? That heat and wave equations we will do during our heat transfer. When we do heat transfer, we will solve heat equations. Okay. So we will, when that is solved, you will get differentiation also. Whatever is required for the syllabus, it will be understood. Okay. Yes. Any doubts here, students? Yeah, any doubts?
Sir, in the previous class, you said force is not a property, right? So is it a point or a path function? Does it fall into those two?
Okay. Force comes under external stimulus.
Oh, okay.
Right. Force comes under external stimulus. Externally, you're stimulating it.
It's not a function.
Not a function. It's externally, you're applying it. Okay. I will go deep into it, okay? But it's not a property at all. Okay, force is not a property at all. Okay? Weight is a property. Weight of a system is a property, but not force. I'll come back to that again, students, okay? Done, students? Write it slowly, don't worry. Tomorrow morning, our Manoj sir will start with casting, okay? So, and after this initial, we have the mechanics and our calculus is completed. Then I will start with the heat transfer, okay? In the morning classes, okay? So like that it will be. Okay? Then after heat transfer is complete, I will take fluid. And morning classes, Manoj sir will complete the whole, in the sense, the manufacturing part, okay? First, initially, he will go with casting, then forming. Then he will go with the machining, non-traditional machining, okay? So what will happen is the people who have started from March 1st, okay? For them, the portion will be completed somewhere in October only, okay? And attending full-fledged classes now, okay? And the people who have started from today, for them, it will take till around December 15th, okay? To complete the syllabus. Then you have 1.5 months to revise. Previously, we used to start from June, students. So when we started from June, there was initially we used to go with 4 hours. Slowly, we used to increase to 6 hours. Then we used to go with 8 hours, okay? But now we don't have that luxury. From first day only, we have to go with 7 or 8 hours of classes. Okay. Let us not waste one more year. We will put full effort, students. There are around in a day, you have to work around 13 to 14 hours. Okay, leave, sleep. 6 hours, 7 hours sleep is enough. Come out of all the distractions, okay? We will struggle for the 6 months and we will get that glory, okay? The high rank in gate, okay? And once you get that, job is there, okay? Everybody who is saying that we don't have a job, mechanical engineers don't get jobs, we will get a job, okay? Very good jobs, because the economy is growing and government is spending a lot on economy, okay? So we will get the job in PSUs or government jobs, okay? Yes. And if you miss that, then because of your knowledge which you have gained through GATE, you will get into big companies also. Last time I was, sent some job for Schaeffler. Schaeffler is a company. Okay, lot of companies are coming to India, students. Okay, we are one of the fastest growing economy now. Okay, although we are not the fastest now, China is better than us. Okay, but still we are improving. Okay, the general mindset about India is improving. Okay, and you will get opportunities. Okay, yeah. Done, students. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Very good. Sir. Please tell me. Okay. Now let us go with exact and inexact definition. Now, in general, if you say a function X or function Z is a function of X comma Y, I will say generally. Okay. A function Z is a function of X comma Y. If I want to say what is dz, if I want to say what is dz, I will say dz as dou z by dou x into dx plus dou z by dou y into dy. This is general. This is, we are going to use this extensively to derive Maxwell's equations. We are going to use this to derive relationship between different things like entropy, pressure, okay, entropy, pressure, temperature, enthalpy, these relations between these two. I will tell you, students, after this session, after this subject being completed, you can derive any relationship between different thermodynamic quantities you will be able to define. Okay, so it's very important that mathematics has to be learned. Only then physics can be learned better. Okay, so now this in general, I can say here, you keep in mind here when I say this, I keep x, y constant, very important. And when it is here, I keep x constant, correct? So when I say this, y is equal to constant, x is equal to constant. This I maintain, correct? Now this can be written as, I can write dz, this can be written as dz is equal to m dx plus n dy, where m is equal to dou z by dou x at y is equal to constant. Okay, or I'll write it as y only. It means that y is constant. Okay, and n is equal to dou z by dou y at x is equal to constant. Okay, now another point, if you see, okay, if I consider dou m by dou z, what is dou m by dou z? Dou m by dou z can be dou m by dou y. If I consider dou m by, wait a minute, students, let me write it neatly. So if I consider dou m by dou y, if I consider, this is nothing but dou by dou z. I use dou as a word, students. It can be used as partial. Partial is the right way to use. Partial by partial z. Partial by partial z. Okay. Divided by partial x. Divided by partial y. Okay. Partial x for partial y. That is equal to dou square x by, not dou z, I'm sorry, dou x. So dou y, I'm sorry, student, this is mistaken. This is dou z by dou x. Make sense? Okay, dou z by dou x. That can be written as dou square z by dou y, dou x. Make sense? Similar way, if you see the other side, okay, what is dou n by, this is one side, then dou m by dou x, if I consider, that is dou by dou x of dou z by dou y at constant y. And this will come as dou square z by dou x dou y. Okay. Now, if z is a point function, if z is a point function or exact function then dou m by dou y is equal to dou n by dou x. Very, very important. So dou m by dou y is equal to dou n by dou x. Very important. Okay. So how we see whether it's a property or not? We see whether dou m by dou x, dou y is equal to dou n by dou x. Okay. If that is the case, z is a property. Otherwise, it is not a property. Make sense? Now, if it is a property, then I will tell you what happens. Okay. Let us take an example and we will see. It is not just like that. Okay. Write this down, students. Okay, this is just I have told the theory only, but there is in-depth knowledge to this. Okay. Done, students? Very good. Okay. Now, what happens if it is a property? Okay. Now, the question is, sir, you're saying if it is a property, there's what happens actually? If it is a property, if Z is a property, then integration of 1 to 2 dz is actually equal to z2 minus z1. If it is not a property, then it will not be equal to. For example, if I say x and y, okay, if I say x and y, and you have 2 points, 1 to 2, and you have to find the z between this. This has one has a property z, and this one, the property is defined. Z is a function of x and y, okay. So z here, okay, and z here, it is independent of the path which is followed. Okay, it's independent of the path which is followed. Means what? Delta's integration of 1 to 2 dz is equal to value what is there at z2 minus value which is there at z1. Simple. Okay. If it is not, it is a property. Okay. If it is not, then it is a path function. It is not a property. Okay. Similar way, if it is a cyclic process. For example, if it is a cyclic process, so from here it starts and then it goes everywhere and it comes down here. Okay, a cyclic process. Okay, so if it is a cyclic process, then what happens? For a cyclic process, cyclic integral of dz is equal to 0. Very important. For a cyclic process. Okay, if z is a property, very important. If z is a property, only then property. If z is not a property, then cyclic integral may not be equal to 0. Like we have our work, is it not? Like we have our heat. okay, this is, these are path functions, correct? Yes. Let us take another example, okay, of this. Very, very small, write it neatly, big letters, okay, in your notes, okay, so that when you see it only, you will be able to get what is path function and what is path point function. Write it neatly, students. Make a neat notes. I know my handwriting is not that great, okay, but still your handwriting should be nice and you should be writing neatly on your paper, okay.
Finish, sir.
Well, okay. Now, next point. Okay, let us take an example and see. Let us take an example which is very understandable, which is length of a curve. Length of a curve, we know it is not a property. Okay. For example, let us take length of a curve, okay, between points, say, x and y. Let us take a property length of a curve. So, we will have point from point 1, from point 2. We will go from one length to the other length, okay, the two lengths which are going, okay, so we know this length of this curve between joining 1 and 2, okay, by two different curves. Let us take, it is going from 1 to 2 along A and 1 to 2 along B, two different curves. Now, how do you define the length of the curve? Okay, this is done in calculus. Okay, if you say delta L at any point delta L square is equal to dx square plus dy square, correct, students? Okay, dx square plus dy square, that is delta L square, correct? Now L1 to 2 is nothing but 1 to 2 into dl, correct? Or delta L, okay, 1 to 2 delta L, correct? You have to differentiate this delta L, correct? We have to integrate, and this comes out to be, when you do it, okay, it comes out to be integration of 1 to 2, okay, square root of 1 plus dy by dx. This is a rule, student. This we will derive in calculus, okay. It is 1 to 2 square root of 1 plus dy by dx into dx, correct? So, this way when you do it, you will see that when you do this, you will see that whether you follow which path, it makes a sense, okay? Because dx depends on from where to where you go, because every y, dy, at every x, whether you take here or whether you take here, dy by dx changes. Make sense? Here dy by dx is different, here dy by dx is different. So when you go through this line, this quantity is different. When you go through A, the quantity is different. So what happens? Integration of 1 to 2 along A, let me say along A, okay, delta L along A is not equal to integration of 1 to 2 d delta L along B. So what happens? This implies that this implies that length of a curve is not a point function. It's actually stupid to say that. It's all trivial to say that, okay? But in mathematics, we have to prove even what is trivial, okay? Yes. Make sense, students?
Sir, in that length of 1 to 2, in that integral from 1 to 2 root of 1 plus dy by dx, shouldn't it be whole square?
I'm sorry, yes, I'm sorry. Okay. It's square, I'm sorry. Very bad, my bad. Square, okay, dy by dx whole square. Makes sense. Thank you. So we will see much more things tomorrow, students. Okay, we will do an example of path function. Okay, and some problems we will do to understand this path function much better. Okay, and then we will see. Okay.
Sir, your delta L is the length, right?
Yes, length of the curve. Yes.
Dx, dy are coordinates.
Yes, x and y are coordinates, yes.
Sir, how delta L square is equal to dx or plus dy square?
I will derive that in calculus, man. Okay. I will derive that in calculus. It's simple one, but still, okay, we will do derive that in calculus. Okay. So delta L, when you take, what we can do here is see exactly this can be done like this. Okay. See, when you say dx square plus dy square, okay. Now what I can do, I can say 1 plus dy by dx, the whole square, correct? I can take dx square, okay, the whole square. And then when I divide by something, I have to multiply also, is it not? Dx. And this dx can come outside, is it not? So if I have a root, okay, dx square is there, right? The dx square can come outside and you get dx, is it not? Here. So this has to be dx square, make sense? Okay, and this dx square can come out and you can write dy by dx the whole square, square root into dx. Make sense? Make sense, Diviraj?
No, sir. I was asking the first equation, like, how is that? It is equation for right.
Pythagoras.
Pythagoras. No, yeah.
This comes from Pythagoras.
Yeah, so how did we apply to that curve? Because delta L is a length from 1 to 2, no? Along the curve.
Delta L, when you say, you take a small part of the curve. And this is delta L. Very, very small. Delta, when you say, it's very small. Delta L. Okay? And that, you are integrating delta L from 1 to 2. That's what it means. You are adding up everything. Okay? Yeah, that's good that you have asked this, because I thought this is very understandable, but sometimes we have to go to this depth and we have to tell. Okay, yes, good. Okay, students, thank you very much. Okay, if you have finished.